Let's try this end of the year press conference thing again, shall we? In my first days as Speaker, I outlined four things that I think we need to do to get our House back on track. Today, I want to provide you a brief update. First, we need to get the House working again as the founders intended it to work. So far, we've opened up the process. More amendments, more conference committees, more new members on conference committees. In 2016, we will make it our goal to pass all 12 appropriation bills through regular order. This has been done. This hasn't been done since 1994, but it's how Congress ought to operate so that we can better protect the taxpayer dollars and make our place the true representative body that it is. Second, we need to find common ground without compromising our principles. So far, we've gotten some big things done doing that. Transportation, defense, education, customs, just in about 6 weeks. I feel good about where we are on both the spending and tax bills that are being discussed or being considered today and tomorrow as well. The spending bill has some big wins for the country, whether it's lifting the oil export ban, increasing military spending, or renewing health care for the 9/11 first responders. And with this tax bill, finally with this tax bill, families and businesses are going to have the long-term certainty that they need instead of scrambling year after year to find out what's next. Third, we need to be an effective opposition party. This spending bill reins in the IRS. It stops the EPA overreach. It blocks the several Obamacare provisions. And it prevents a taxpayer bailout of the Risk Corps the Risk Corridor program. And when we return in January, the House will put an Obamacare repeal bill on the floor and pass it and put it on the president's desk. This bill will also defund Planned Parenthood. We are going to keep working to give families relief from this law while we work to dismantle it and replace it altogether. Which brings me to the fourth point. We need to be a proposition party. 2016, we are going to be a proposition party. As I told our members this week, I didn't become Speaker to sit in a room and make big decisions on big bills. I became Speaker to give us a horizon to shoot for, to lift our gaze so that we can show the American people who we are and what we believe and what we're going to do to solve their problems. That's why our top goal in 2016 is going to be to put together a bold, pro-growth agenda for the country. We will offer the people of this nation a real choice and a plan to restore a confident America at home and abroad. This work will begin at our retreat next month. So I feel good about where we are right now. I feel good about what we've been able to accomplish in just a few short weeks. And I feel very good about where we're going in the next year. With that, I'd be happy to answer your questions.
Mr. Ryan, why are you, Kenny Starr with CNS News, why are you waiting?
Yeah, thank you for introducing yourselves, yeah.
Why are you waiting until, why isn't the defunding plan in the
omnibus? It's in the reconciliation bill. The reconciliation bill was the vehicle we chose long ago. We could get that through the Senate. We knew we couldn't get it through the Senate in any other way. And we're going to bring it up and have it pass. I think we're going to do the first week we get back from after the new year.
Ryan, there's some angst in your conference right now about H-2B visas for foreign workers. Senator Sessions says that it will cause higher unemployment and lower wages for Americans. The seasonal workers will go from 66,000 to 250,000. Judiciary put it in, but the buck stops with you. What do you say to your fellow members of the Congress?
I think these things kind of happen at the end with these bills. This policy went through the committee process. This policy was passed by the full Appropriations Committee in July with consultation and approval by the House Judiciary Committee. So if you have any questions about this, the substance of the proposal, I'll refer you to the Judiciary Committee. But this has been out there for a long time. Our members had listening sessions with the appropriators all during the construction of this bill itself. Again, this passed in the House Judiciary Committee in July with the House. They passed the House Appropriations Committee in July with the House Judiciary Committee working with that committee. So if you got any questions, I'd refer you to those guys. The whole point of this, I want the committees driving the process. I want the committees writing the legislation, and that's what happened here.
You think you'll still be okay, though, overall?
I do. I think we're doing fine. Chad.
You said yesterday that you thought these bills would pass with wide bipartisan support, and you say, you know, we hear this consternation at the very end here and back and forth. But are you convinced, are you pretty solid that this mix is right on both bills?
Yeah, I feel pretty good about where we are. Like I say, you always find out when the vote comes. Let me say this. you know I don't like this process, right? I mean, you know that we inherited a process, a cake that was pretty much more than half baked. I don't like the way that these bills come together because I think we should do these separately, individually, through what we call regular order. That's why I just started this press conference saying, next year, we're going to do things differently. Next year, when we have a fresh start, we're doing things differently because I don't think this is the way that we should be governing. But we are where we are, and we have a bipartisan compromise where, by the way, I think we've got some good wins. And look, Democrats won some things, too. That's the nature of bipartisan compromises. And so the way I look at this is, we have made the best of the situation we have. There are some really good wins in here for the American people. There are very good wins in here for the economy, for job creators, for taxpayers. There are some important developments in here that will help us build a confident America. But as Congress works in the new year, I want to make sure that we get back to what is called regular order so that we have a system that operates like the founders intended. And I feel very good that we're getting off on that good start next year. Yeah. Right.
Do you need the president next year? And can you talk a little bit about...
Do I need the president next year? Do you really want me to answer that? No, I'm just kidding. Look, we disagree just profoundly with the president on so many issues. And we will oppose his agenda where we disagree, and that's on a lot of things, and I think we've shown that. But we feel, because we think the country is headed in the wrong direction, because the president's policies have now been in place for 7 years, it's not working. Look at poverty, look at wages, look at the economy, look at foreign policy, look at the military, look at regulations. This isn't what a confident America looks like. So we owe the country a better agenda, a better way forward. We owe the country a fresh approach, a new plan, and that's what we're going to do. And so, no, it doesn't require the president. We don't agree with the president. This is why we are going to roll out our own pro-growth agenda, which will stand in stark contrast to the agenda that's been pushed through here in the last 7 years. Jonathan.
Jonathan Nicholson from Bloomberg BNN. On that issue of the agenda for next year, you talked about trying to do an ACA replacement and tax reform. And I was curious, you said you don't think those would actually be signed before.
Correct.
Do you think that you'll have actual scoreable legislation on those two issues? And B, is it any tip to try and do some smaller stuff on smaller issues where there might be common ground?
Yeah.
I
think they're both, so on all issues other than, I think budget process reform, they're like biennial, for example. I think there's a chance where we might have some bipartisan consensus. We've got to do two things next year. We have to walk and chew gum at the same time. We have to look for common ground to advance the common good where we think we can find good things to do together. And we've done that just this year. Transportation is a good one. Education's another one. What we're passing this week. So we've got to continue to find common ground. But we also have to offer the country a clear choice. We have to put alternatives out there. And so are we ever going to have a law repealing Obamacare signed in law by a president named Obama? I kind of doubt that. That is why we're going to put out our own alternatives. And I can't tell you what the score is going to be in all of this, because this is going to be a decentralized system. Our members are going to participate from the bottom up organically in assembling this agenda. So what I want to see happen in 2016 is everybody who ran for Congress and came to the Republican conference has an equal say-so on how we're going to assemble this agenda and take our case to the American people, because we think that's the choice they deserve.
Just to be clear, are you saying there will be legislation?
I'm not saying either. Yeah.
Mr. Speaker, when you talk about putting out this bold agenda, are you going to actually bring these bills to the floor and have the House vote on them so you can show how...
Sort of like what Jonathan said, that's going to be decided by our members. So that's why I say I don't want to presume to have it all figured out, because we haven't, as a team, decided exactly when and under what context we're going to be rolling our agenda out. So those are details to be decided jointly as a House Republican caucus in concert with our friends over in the Senate. Yeah. Is the House going to be around that much next year?
Not in session a lot.
Oh, I see.
What are you going to be doing in 2016 when you're not here?
Well, my routines are pretty well known. So let me start with the first thing. This job is an absolute honor. You know, I always watch this job from the outside, never wanting to go into elected leadership, always wanting to be a policymaker. and becoming a chair to work on the issues I really cared about. And I was honored to do that. First of all, I'm thankful for the people of Wisconsin's first district to give me this chance. And I'm grateful to my colleagues for asking me to and become speaker, for putting me in this position. It's a great honor. It's a tremendous responsibility. And I'm going to exercise this responsibility to the best of my abilities. And one of the things that I've always thought this place needed was more regular order, more participation, democratizing the institution, small d democratizing. And that's something that I think we've done. I think what I have found in the last 6 weeks is by opening up this process, by having more member involvement, by having the place work the way it was intended, is we've taken a lot of pressure out of the system. I think members feel like they can come and do their jobs better, and I think constituents as a result are better represented. So I feel very proud of what we've been able to accomplish here in just a couple months. And I'm excited about getting on to the rest of our agenda in 2016.
Back on the next year's agenda, and then also one follow up on this. You've talked about the incumbent president. What about an agenda that gets out in front of the list of your nominee?
Well, I said this before. We may not have a nominee till, I don't know, June or July. I think it's a little late to all of a sudden show the country who we are and what we believe and what we're going to do if they give us the honor of being in the majority and having the White House and being able to pass our agenda. We know who we are. We know what we believe in. We know what our principles are. So we ought to take those principles and apply them to the big wrenching problems of the day to offer the American people real solutions to their problems and to give them a very clear choice. The way I see this coming down is it ought to be up to the people of America to decide what America looks like after 2016. And we have a role to play in that. And basically punting and kicking the can down until the summer, I don't think is a good use of our time. That's why we're going to be beginning the assembling of our agenda as soon as we come back out of New Year's.
And have you lost a bunch of weight since you became
CEO? Have I lost a bunch of weight? Does it look like it?
Estimate,
oh, really? No, I stay the same. I've weighed the same, like within like 2 or 3 pounds for like the last 20 years. So no, I haven't lost any weight. That's pretty good.
Thank you.
Oh, hey, one more thing. Merry Christmas, happy holidays.
All right. Our special operations forces are hard at work. We took out the ISIL leader in Libya. We've taken out terrorists in Yemen and Somalia. So we're sending a message. If you target Americans, you will have no safe haven. We will find you, and we will defend our nation.